everybody. My name is Carmen Shank, and I am back again with another installment of the Right Size Your Kitchen Video Challenge. Today, we're going to tackle the spice cabinet. Yay! And this is another place where you can really make a big difference with not a lot of effort. So let's get started, shall we? Go through your spice cabinet, pull everything out, clean it, and get ready to put back the good stuff, okay? Now, if you're like me, you probably have some spice containers in there that you haven't used in quite some time. If you haven't used it in a year or more, it might be an indicator that you're not going to use it. So it's okay to empty the contents into your compost and recycle the container. It's okay, not a problem. Now, if you found some spices that you really love that you've run out of, then it's maybe time to replace a few. Now, I know a lot of folks go to the grocery store and buy the little bitty bottles. I don't do that. I tend to buy my spices in bulk. Now there's two solutions here. My favorite is AtlanticSpiceCompany.com, and I will buy a pound at a time. It comes in a small plastic bag. It's easy to recycle. There's no containers. I get to use my own containers. For spices that I use a lot of, I do keep them in the quart jars. Now, in our tiny house, I go with a jelly jar. That's a much smaller container, and you might even consider the smaller canning jar as well. These little teeny tiny ones are really great for spices. Now, in our neighborhood, we have this sweet little shop that has bulk spices, and we can go in there and buy a teaspoon of something, or a cup of something, or a pound of something. It doesn't matter. The prices are a little bit on the high side, but you don't have to deal with the container. You can put it in whatever container is right for you. And you kind of can keep an eye on some of those places, and you can kind of get a feel, if you go back pretty often, how fresh their spices are. How often are they refilling those bins that you're using from? And that's important to keep an eye on, because spices that are old, ground herbs and stuff like that, especially, they will begin to lose some flavor over time. So as it's been in your kitchen for a while, if a recipe calls for a teaspoon, you might want to, if it's been around for a while, double that or even triple it. If you're not using fresh spices, you may not be getting the impact the recipe was actually hoping you would get. So, like I said, my favorite spice company is AtlanticSpice.com. I buy a number of things in pound packages, like smoked paprika. The price is very reasonable if you buy it by a pound. Another one of my favorites is applewood smoked sea salt, and this is very nice as well. Now, don't buy anything with liquid smoke in it. It's just a really dangerous carcinogen, so make sure if it's a smoked product, it's actually smoked and not just added liquid salt. I mean liquid smoke, because that stuff's really bad. So go through your spices, get rid of the empties, anything you don't use very much that's been around a year or longer, go ahead and empty that into your compost and recycle the container, okay? Now, one of the things that I have really fallen in love with recently, and I know it may seem like a fad, but I'm enjoying using essential oils. Now, there are a number of ways that I use these little gems in my tiny house. If I'm making a salad dressing, for example, that I usually make a little bit of salad dressing in the bowl before I add the salad, okay, before I add the lettuce or anything. And instead of storing a bottle of salad dressing in the fridge, I don't buy bottles of salad dressing. I make it as I go along, and I will keep on hand a good oil, like olive oil, and a good vinegar, like balsamic or apple cider vinegar or whatever. You know, I'll just keep those things on hand and make a new dressing each time, which is really easy and fun to do with an essential oil. You can add a lot of flavor and a lot of just flavor punch with a drop or two drops of an essential oil. For example, lemon, oregano, basil, cinnamon. There's all kinds of choices. There's all kinds of citrus. There's orange, tangerine, lemon, lime, jade lemon, and there's all kinds of spices as well. So you can add them to your salad dressing as you make the salad dressing in the bowl before you add the salad. You can use them to flavor desserts. I use them in my buttercream recipe, add a couple of drops of lemon to buttercream icing, and it's an amazing thing suddenly. You can also add them to chocolate ganache and make the centers for a truffle. So you just add a couple of drops of essential oils into the ganache, let it set up in the fridge, and then pull it out, make the balls, and then dip them in chocolate, and they're amazing. You can add some really exotic flavors to chocolate ganache that way. For example, cinnamon is good, orange is really good. I used bergamot and made an Earl Grey truffle filling, which is really good. Lemon, of course, is really good, and there's lots of others. There's so many great choices. Lemongrass is a little bit more exotic. You can add clove or nutmeg or coriander or any of these essential oils may make a really interesting truffle filling. So that's an option as well. Now, if you're going to add it to your cooking, add it at the end, because if you put it into the process and really cook the if you put it like in a pot of boiling water with a soup or something, it may evaporate off the surface of the boiling water. And so that may not be the best way to use it. But if you add it to the soup when it's cooling down and put it in right at the end as you stir it in, you'll get the flavor punch without just evaporating it all into the kitchen. So it's important to kind of pay attention to where you're using it. Now, I have basil, oregano, and some of the spices, the herbs that I use in essential oils as well as in the spices. And it's up to you. If you play with it a little bit and find some things that you like, essential oils may help you to get some of the bulkier spices out of your cabinet. Plus, they're good for a lot of other things. And of course, you can Google, you know, peppermint, lemon, lavender. You can Google those things, those combinations, and those individual essential oils, and find out the ways that they're really useful. Okay, so go through your spice cabinet today. Take a look at each individual that's in there. If you want to take the time and get bulk spices and put them in your own jars, that's fine. If you want to, you know, stick with a brand where all of your spice containers look the same, that's fine. Whatever you like to do with your spice cabinet, today is the day that you dive in, clean it out, get rid of the stuff you're not using, and maybe even try a new spice. If you've got an empty space left in your cabinet and you want to try something new, go for it. These flavors, there's so many amazing choices and so many amazing options. And adding spices and herbs and essential oils to our food is a really great way to try something new and change it up again. And some of these guys don't take up much space, so that's really good in the tiny house world. So I'm Carmen Shank. I hope you will try some new spices and clean out your kitchen cabinet spice rack today. Okay, I know you can do it. I know you can. I'm Carmen Shank, the tiny house foodie, reminding you that we can go tiny, we can embrace simplicity, and we can eat really well. Thanks for joining me. I appreciate it.